Congressman, I know you got to go. You got other activities up on Capitol Hill. We're going to let you go, but everyone else is staying because we have a lot more to discuss, especially, Congressman, you'll be interested in this, the latest post on HuffingtonPost.com by Arianna. What she wrote about the vice president today is fascinating material. It's going to be a source of good discussion here. But what has she written about? She's written about the vice president, and she's suggesting perhaps this might be a good moment for him to think about resigning. Why? Why would the Vice President Joe Biden want to resign? The best political team on television and Arianna Huffington, they're here to dissect this high drama idea. We're back with our senior political analyst Gloria Borger, Republican strategist Kevin Madden, our senior political correspondent Candy Crowley, and Arianna Huffington of the Huffington Post, who's written a rather provocative essay today, Arianna. It involves the Vice President of the United States. Tell our viewers in the United States and around the world what you think.
Well, Wolf, you know, reading the cover story on Joe Biden in Newsweek this week, I was really moved by his clear opposition to the war and some of the methods he's using in the Situation Room in the White House to try and actually shift the president's decision. So given that, I thought it would be really important if the vice president, instead of waiting until after the fact to write the inevitable mea culpa memoir, telling us how forceful he was behind the scenes in opposing the war and how sorry he was that he wasn't listened, that he can actually do the right thing right now. And if this president chooses to escalate, he should resign. That would be such an powerful statement of principle that would really make a fundamental difference, because, Wolf, there is nothing more important than a matter of war and peace like this, a matter that affects our national security, and Joe Biden could provide the leadership that is really needed if we are going to change course.
Arianna, wouldn't you argue, though, that Joe Biden has had a tremendous amount of influence, he's changed the arc of the conversation, and that he's more likely to influence the President of the United States being inside that room, not only now but in the future, than he would if he just said, oh, okay, fine, I'm just going to resign?
Well, Gloria, I completely agree that he has influenced the arc of the conversation. He has had a big difference. But right now, the president is about to make up his mind. I'm told by my own sources, and I'm sure you're being told by yours, that the decision is going to be the president will split the difference. He's not going to give General McChrystal the 40,000 troops that he's asked for, but he's not going to give him nothing. And that is the moment for Vice President Biden to resign. That is the moment when he can have a real impact on the president's decision.
How can you expect a vice president to resign every time the president doesn't take his advice totally? It's better to have him in that room. Resigning would be empty.
Gloria, I'm sorry to disagree with you, but I don't consider a matter of war and peace every time. I don't ask him to resign over the Recovery Act or the bailout or any number of things over which he may disagree with the president. But we've seen historically over Vietnam, over Iraq, how many great leaders, including Colin Powell, did not do the right thing at a moment when it could have made a difference. This is another critical moment. This is a moment when actually many forces across the political spectrum are coming together to oppose escalation in Afghanistan, ranging from George Will and Richard House, the head of the Council of Foreign Relations, and Chuck Hagel. This is not a right versus left issue. This is the moment for real leadership, and there is nothing more noble than resigning over a matter of national security, which is at stake here. As Congressman Jim McGovern has said, we are becoming less safe in Afghanistan. This country is becoming less safe because of what's happening.
Kevin Madden, Republican strategist, wants to weigh in.
Arianna, with all due respect, don't you believe that you're kind of misreading the role of the vice president? Joe Biden signed on to this administration, agreed to be President Obama's running mate, with the full knowledge that the president was going to make these decisions, and with a good two-year evidentiary trail of what the president's plan would be for Afghanistan. The president himself said on the campaign trail that we took our eye off the ball by going to Iraq and we needed to put it back on Afghanistan. So by keeping his word, why should a vice president who signed on to that very word that he gave to the American people resign?
Everybody who is in the administration needs to be loyal to the president. No question about that. But there is a higher loyalty. And the higher loyalty is to the American people. And this is really this moment. As for the facts about Afghanistan, we have so much new information, Kevin. We know, for example, as General Jones himself said, that there are now 100 Al-Qaeda members in Afghanistan. They have moved to a different neighborhood. They've moved to Pakistan. And yet, as Vice President Biden effectively says in the Newsweek article, he elicits that information. We are spending $65 billion this year in Afghanistan and $2.5 billion in Pakistan. There is a huge disconnect between the reality on the ground and the illusions that are at the moment guiding our foreign policy in Afghanistan.
I want everybody to stand by for just a moment.
This is CNN breaking news.
And the breaking news just coming into the Situation Room involves Rush Limbaugh and his interest in becoming a part owner of the NFL St. Louis Rams. Brian Todd is getting the story for us. Brian, what are you just learning?
Wolf, we've just gotten word that the ownership group that is bidding to buy the St. Louis Rams, has just dropped Rush Limbaugh from its list of potential partners. That group just releasing a statement from Dave Checkitz, its chairman, saying, quote, of Limbaugh, it has become clear that his involvement in our group has become a complication and a distraction to our intentions, endangering our bid to keep the team in St. Louis. As such, we have decided to move forward without him and hope it will eventually lead us to a successful conclusion. Of course, this has kind of reached critical mass over the past couple of days. The head of the NFL Players Union coming out very strongly against Mr. Limbaugh's effort to join that group or to be part of that group bidding for the Rams. And also the NFL Commissioner Roger Goodell coming out in the last couple of days expressing his reservations as well. This, of course, all goes back to Rush Limbaugh's comments in years past about race, making a comment that watching an NFL game was a little bit like watching the Bloods and the Crips without the weapons. He also intimated some years back on ESPN that Philadelphia Eagles quarterback Donovan McNabb was overrated and being overhyped because he is African-American. All of that coming back now to bite Rush Limbaugh a little bit. He is dropped now as part of that ownership group bidding to buy the St. Louis Rams.
All right, Brian, thank you. Kevin Madden, what do you think?
Well, I think this was a business story that unfortunately became a political story, and now it's going to go back to being a business story. The business part of it just goes to show you that at the end of the day, business is about doing business. They had to move forward because of a distraction. On the political side, I'm somewhat troubled that someone in America who would want to join in a business venture would be dissuaded from being, or discouraged from doing so, because he has political adversaries out there that want to prevent him from doing so.
How do you feel, Arianna?
Well, I don't think it's a question of having political adversaries. It's more the fact that he's radioactive. And the truth is that it's not just political adversaries, people who disagree with him, who object to Rush Limbaugh. It's anybody who wants a civil discourse in this country, even when we don't agree with each other.
We're going to leave it there. But I want Arianna, just to note, based on everything I've heard from the vice president's aides, he supports keeping the troops at the current level around 68,000, wants there to be a counterterrorism as opposed to a counterinsurgency strategy. But to say that he opposes the war, I think, probably goes too far. But go ahead and correct me if you think I'm wrong.
Well, he opposes the escalation of the war. That's
the escalation is correct, but he doesn't oppose the war in Afghanistan.
No, but opposing the escalation of the war, which is what I'm writing about today, is really what this is all about. You know, if you oppose the escalation and you allow the war to escalate, where is the end? At what point do you say no more? At what point do you put principle above power? That's really the question I'm raising.
It's an excellent point. I just wanted to clarify where the vice president stands. Arianna Huffington, thanks very much. Kevin Madden, thanks to you.
Thank you.
Gloria and Candy, of course, you guys have no choice. You got to go. Thanks to you as well.